My name is Nina Latcheva, and we are in the Marenda Lab at Drexel University. I work with a protein that can alter your DNA, and I'm looking at its involvement in neuronal development. So I was born in Bulgaria. My parents moved here when I was 8, and we moved around a bit, and eventually they settled to Jersey, so I went to Rutgers University for my undergraduate, and a couple years later, I ended up here. I used to watch a lot of Dexter's Lab. It's a cartoon on Cartoon Network back in the day. I don't know if it's still on, but I used to love watching Dexter's Lab, and I used to say that I wanted to be a scientist, just like him. And he would have all these beakers and screwdrivers, things that now I'm like, that's not really related to science, but I would love it, and I would think that that's what science is. So I would collect all kinds of things that I thought were sciencey and play with them when I was little. Some of the motivation, especially for my earlier years in the sciences, came from the fact that my grandfather had Alzheimer's disease and passed away from it, and that led me to really enjoy my undergraduate lab, which was an Alzheimer's lab. And from there, I really learned how much DNA and genetics has to do with not just Alzheimer's, but pretty much any disease out there. So I was really interested in learning more about DNA. So currently I'm working on performing a chip assay, which is chromatin immunoprecipitation. Chromatin is what your DNA is packaged in your cells so that it can fit. There's a ton of DNA, so in order for it to fit in the nucleus of your cells, it's packaged in chromatin. And the way that it's packaged can alter the way that your genes are expressed. So the protein that I work with, kismet, which has a human homolog, CHC7, which is implicated in CHARGE syndrome. So if you only have one copy of CHD7, you get this malformation CHARGE syndrome. The short-term goal of my project would probably be to find a way to modulate the activity of kismet in a way that if you had one copy, like CHARGE syndrome, we would find a way to tweak the protein's activity to increase so that you wouldn't get CHARGE syndrome. I really enjoy working in a lab. It's not as mundane as people like to think it is. Life in the lab is always challenging, and it always keeps you on your toes, which I really enjoy. And in general, if you find a lab that fits, then it's wonderful. You get along with your lab mates. You can't ask for anything better out of a job. If my research turns out to be amazing, I would really like to have my own lab and be able to call the shots on my research. If it's something that you really like, you should do it no matter what. I mean, don't let not being good at math or chemistry or whatever, physics, stop you if you're interested in it. Because ultimately, the things that you're not as good at are the things where you can show the most improvement. And the things that interest you usually are the things you don't quite understand.